This week we're going to talk a little bit about the boundaries that we have set in place in our life. And we're going to be reading from Proverbs once again, chapter 19. Now we jump forward a little bit, and next week we're actually going to dive into Proverbs chapter 31, because this week is going to point to that. However, let's start with this week. And this week talks about the different boundaries that we have. The very first verse of chapter 19 says this: "Better the poor whose walk is blameless than a fool whose lips are perverse." What is it that we do to keep the perverse things out of our lives and then coming out through our mouth? The people around us may swear left and right, and they may say things that we do not want to hear. I've had people who have cussed at me left and right and then realize that I'm a preacher, and they come up and said, "I am so sorry," and I've shared with them, "Listen, don't take the Lord's name in vain. Don't take Jesus' name in vain. Those are the things that I don't want to hear. But the other things, you know what? They're part of life and they're things that I have to deal with. But my kids are with me. Those are not things that I would want my children to hear." So I have to put boundaries in place. And so I'm not afraid to let them know, "Hey, I've got kids with me. Could you please watch what it is that you're saying?" And I've been in grocery stores before where I've heard people take the Lord's name in vain and walked up to them and said, "Are you mad at God for something?" And they're like, "Well, no." And I'm like, "Okay, then why did you just say what you just said?" And they'll tell me, "I'm so sorry, I didn't mean that. Would you please forgive me?" And I'll stop them for a second and say, "Listen, you didn't say John Stallett. You said this instead." So it's something that we need to set boundaries for when it comes to the things that we hear and the things that we say. Are you someone who struggles in this area? In fact, are there other areas that you may struggle in? We're going to take a look this week. Would you ask yourself, what boundaries do I have in place to avoid those things that, quite frankly, I just don't need to hear, because when I hear them, they come through my heart and eventually they come out of me.